Hey, wrestling fans, you're watching Figure 4 Radio here on FlintTalkRadio.com. I am your host, Xavier Justice. You'll have to pardon the brief absence of Mr. Father Time. He is kind of old and his bowels aren't what they used to be, so he's taking a big fat dump, but he'll be back shortly, and he's going to love me for telling you that. But folks, we have got a great show for you today. We have got an action-packed, exciting show. We have got a special guest that's going to be coming in later. That's right, Mr. Bud Slaughter will be back in the house, and guess what? We've got a treat for you. He's going to be playing an acoustic hit song you don't want to miss. Folks, keep tuning in here on FlintTalkRadio.com on Figure 4 Radio, because you will see Bud Slaughter a little later. But before we get to that, we're going to talk about our upcoming event at the Masonic Temple, Friday, March 2nd, where I will step into the ring with MMA international superstar Dingo Brown. Now, Dingo has been fighting all over the world. He's originally here from Flint, Michigan. He's the biggest, baddest cage fighter around, and that's why I chose him. To settle it once and for all, who is tougher, an MMA fighter or a pro wrestler? And folks, if you show up to the Flint Masonic Temple on Saturday, March 2nd, you will see myself, Xavier Justice, in action, a first ever in PPW, a pro wrestler versus MMA fighter match. It is going to be something you don't want to miss. Now, ladies and gentlemen, we have also signed one of the biggest championship matches to date. Chris Corvus re-signed with Pure Pro Wrestling. His contract is in cement, and his first match back in the ring will be against none other than Sebastian Rose for the Michigan State Championship. Folks, this is one you do not want to miss. Chris Corvus is one of the most decorated members of Pure Pro Wrestling that there has ever been. He's won the franchise champion. He's won the television championship. And I'll tell you what, when he was the franchise champion, he was literally champion for an entire year. It still stands right now in Pure Pro Wrestling that he is the longest reigning champion that we have ever seen. Sebastian Rose is vastly approaching that number, so we will see what happens on the night of March 2nd once again at the Flint Masonic Temple. Folks, if you want to buy tickets, you can buy them right now. That's right, you can just open another tab. You can go on your website, www.prowrestlingatitsfinest.com. I'm going to give it to you again. I know it's a long name. www.prowrestlingatitsfinest.com. Now, folks, you can go on there right now. You can order tickets via PayPal. You do not want to miss this. Whoa, is that Father Time?
That's me.
And you kind of stunk up the place,
hey.
Man.
hey.
He did. He kind of stunk up the place.
Yeah, right.
How you doing? How you doing, big guy? There's your seat right there.
Kind of taking care of some business.
I bet. Pinching one off, huh?
Yeah, some kind of prune juice cuts kind of gets back to me.
Well, hold on. We got to get you set up here. There's a headset. All right. Let's get you mic'd up. Boom.
Ain't nothing like a prune to make you move.
Well, we are joined here by my illustrious co-host, Mr. Father Time.
Yes, sir.
I was just talking about the Flint Masonic Temple. I am super excited. Now, we hear you're going to be wrestling in action. That's correct, right?
Yes, sir. I'll be down there. That's next month, isn't it?
It's next month.
On the
it's right around the corner.
Saturday. The Masonic Temple, one of the most beautiful buildings in downtown Flint. But I'll be there. Matter of fact, I was there when they put the first cornerstone in.
100 years ago, yes.
100 years ago.
Yes, and you were still a young man then, weren't you?
quite young.
Well, I'll tell you what are you going to be doing at the temple? I hear there's a new wrestler in PPW. No one's seen him. No one knows about him. We just know he's from the West Coast.
Yes.
He's out from the Vegas area. We don't even have a name on the guy yet. It's billed as Father Time versus a mystery opponent. You know, cliche, but hey, it's got me intrigued. How do you feel about this?
Well,
going into a night where you really don't know who the heck you're facing.
Well, I know he's out there from California, so the first thing I got down was the lingo. Like, hey, dude. So
but I don't know, there's a lot of types of people in California. He may not be a surfer.
But you know something, that's the thing about it. It doesn't really matter with Father Time. Father Time takes them on all, no matter what they are. It just don't matter. Because I've been around for so long, I can adjust to anybody, anytime, anywhere.
I mean, it's feasible that you could be stepping into the ring with a man that's 7 foot tall. We don't know. Are you sure you got this?
I've got it. There's no other way I can say, but I definitely got it. You know, like I always say, it's a crime to fool with Father Time.
that should be on a t-shirt, perhaps. Well, I'll tell you what, I couldn't be more excited for the event. We've got the big championship matchup with Corvus and Rose. We've got Dingo the Destroyer. I mean, I know he calls himself Dingo the Magnificent, but I've seen this guy's fights. He might as well call himself Dingo
the Destroyer. You asked me about my match.
Yeah.
Are you ready for your match?
You know what? I'm excited about my match. I've had so many people get a hold of me online, send me messages, and basically try to talk me out of this fight. They're telling me I'm crazy. And I have to say, I have a little more confidence in myself than that. I tell you what, I take nothing away from this guy. This is why I called him out. I chose him for a reason. I've been dealing with this for years where MMA fighters get onto the website or they show up at the events, and all they do is try to run down what we do. You know, we're out there, putting our lives on the line, you know, to entertain these kids and raise money for the community. And I get a lot of these guys that show up and just talk about how we're fake and how we ain't tough and this and that and blah, blah, blah. And after a while, I just got tired of hearing it. So I decided to do something about it.
Well, you are a doer. Yes, you are.
Yes, I did. I decided to do something about it. I decided to pick a fight with the biggest, meanest, nastiest son of a gun that I could find this side of Flint. And I asked around, and the consensus was that Dingo Brown was the man to challenge if I was going to get into the ring with any MMA fighter.
Well, I got to admit, you did find the biggest, baddest person that I've seen. He was sitting in his chair.
I had to call him the Grave Digger. I tell you what, I've been trying to find matches of this guy. You know, I've been seeing him online. And, you know, I've been trying to study him a little bit just to get prepared. I can't study him. None of his matches last more than 2 rounds. So he's right up my alley.
You mean you're a two-minute man?
Kiss my ass.
That's why you only last 2 minutes. You got the wrong part.
Well, you know, it's hard to study for a guy. But the thing is, you know, I know I'm in tremendous shape. I'm in the best shape of my life
right now.
Yeah,
you are. I've got to admit that.
And, you know, I've taken a lot of blows to the head. So, you know what, I'm not worried about that. The big thing is, you know, my strategy is going to be to tire him out. You know, he's a bigger guy. He's 6'5".
6'5".
You know, he's over 300 pounds. He's a big dude, and he's never been in a wrestling ring. It's a lot different than a square circle.
You might have some advantage over him because
I feel I do, but to the same extent, I'm not stupid. I know if this guy gets his hands on me and we're down on the mat, it's going to be a different story. So, you know, I'm training on my quickness. I'm training on my strikes, my mat techniques. I tell you, I've been really working on quick suplexes. I've been really working on devastating moves because, I mean, this guy's 6'5". He's 300 pounds. Got to find a way to put him down. I'm not stupid. I know I'm going into this, possibly the odds are stacked against me, and you know, and I give him credit for doing this. Honestly, you know, I had to get him riled up a little bit, kind of had to piss him off, say a few things that, you know, upset him, which may end up being a negative thing for me in the end. But you know what, I got him to accept the fight, and I got to give him credit for stepping into something that really he knows nothing about.
Right, that's true.
And
that's true.
You know, normally, you know, when you're a fighter, you have time to prepare. You know what you're getting into,
right?
And this just gives a testament to the kind of athlete this guy is, stepping into the ring for the first time. You know, with the head trainer of Pure Pro Wrestling. I'm not here to toot my own horn, but I will say I know what I'm doing. And when push comes to shove, March 2nd rolls around, I'm going to give Dingo a run for his money, and I am confident that I can beat this man.
Well, you know, like I said, I've been in the gym with you. I've been seeing you been trained. I've never seen you train this hard over the last 3 years. Yeah. I seem like this is something that you have really put your mindset on. No matter what happens.
You know, I got something to prove, man. It's all about this. I got something to prove. Well, once again, you know, these MMA guys think that what we do is not legit. They think that what we do is fake, that we're not tough. You know, and it's a load of crap. And I get tired of being disrespected. So I figure, you know what? Hey, if I beat the man, that's one thing. If I survive him, that's another. And if I do survive the man, or hey, if I can beat the man, then I've proved something that, you know what, pro wrestlers are just as tough as we say we are. And maybe some of these haters out there will shut their mouth.
But, you know, I'm waiting. We'll see.
Hey, man, I can take an ass whooping. It's all about getting back up.
I've seen you get up so many different times.
Mm-hmm, that's
right. I got to give you respect. Anytime a man can survive a broken neck, well, I know this man can survive anything. So I tell you what, I give you all the kudos you deserve.
Well, I appreciate that. But, you know, I'm not doing it for bragging rights. A lot of guys get into this for the glory of it. But I'm not doing it for brag rights. Once again, it's just to prove a point and prove something to myself. And I know I'm considered the underdog in this thing, but I tell you what, you know, I don't feel that way. I feel confident. I feel strong in my abilities. And I know if I can get this guy tired, I got him where I want him.
What? I just, you know, if I didn't know you, I would have thought you were crazy.
Well, maybe I am a little bit. But it takes a crazy man to get in the ring to begin with.
Well, I mean, look at me. As old as I'm in here,
right.
I'm
doing I thought you were crazy when you strolled into the Justice League.
But three, that's 4 years difference. Ago. I'll admit that I am.
Well, you know, delusional crazy, it's all the same to me.
Yeah, okay.
We've got a guest. We've got a special guest, don't we? He's ready to rock, man. Okay, Bud Slaughter of the Bud Slaughter Band. He's going to be appearing March 2nd with his band playing their new hit single. You haven't even heard it yet. You haven't seen it yet. It's not even released. He's going to play it before it hits the airwaves. He's going to play it before the CD drops. I can't wait. Bud Slaughter is going to be stepping into the ring. Actually, he'll be on stage playing, but, anything can happen in a PPW.
That's true.
Welcome, brother.
Hey.
Welcome.
Hey, how you doing?
Let's welcome back Bud Slaughter of the Bud Slaughter Band. You got your guitar with you. What's going on, man?
I'm going to do a number here from the
You're gonna play for us?
Album.
All right.
Bud Slaughter Band's got a couple of acoustic songs and.
This is exciting. We're gonna get an exclusive performance from Bud Slaughter. Unbelievable! I can't wait.
As always, it's great to be out here on Flint Talk Radio, and thanks to John Wilson for having me on, and thanks to Pure Pro Wrestling for everything.
Oh boy, we're waiting.
All right, this song's off the Tattooed Soul CD.
Absolute treat from Mr. Bud Slaughter. And just real briefly, could you tell us a little bit about that song and some of your inspiration behind it?
Well, that was a song. Well, I mean, that's kind of a lot of people. I do hate to say goodbye. I guess if you're going to, you don't want to be friends with me, just tell me to F off and go on your way. I guess. I mean, that's kind of what it's about, you know. And,
right?
Yeah.
Don't string you along. Don't BS you, right?
It's going to have the same outcome. Just
Fair enough. That's excellent. Excellent.
Well, you know, I'm really glad I've been here, you know, last week. And I enjoyed you last week. And
thank you.
And I will enjoy you more this week. Well, this is all right.
And we got a little bit of a preview of what we're going to see at March 2nd at the Masonic Temple. Right. I can't wait.
What were you guys asking me to do? A number here?
Yeah. You know, if you got the time, we'll listen, brother.
All right.
Let's...
Hey,
what the hell?
Hey,
what's wrong?
Hey, I don't know, man.
Oh, shit.
Yeah, I don't know.
So,
whoa, man, what are you doing? What's this guy
doing? What's going on?
Well, this is Dingo Brown,
this
folks.
This is Dingo Brown. This is
the, no, hey, I didn't sign up for all this.
Hey, man, you know, you got to make an appointment to come
in. I'm not
in
a referee, a wrestler.
You know that, right? You got to make an appointment to come and get interviews. And your time was last week, and it's definitely not now. I got a guest on. You're being
just
rude.
Like,
you can't just
buy it. My wedding is going to be my house. Step on in there, man. Wherever I set foot is my house.
Really?
Pretty much.
Listen, guys, come on. I got a
really
mellow
song. You can't just walk in and, dude, you're disrespecting Bud Slaughter, and he's a rock and roll legend.
Bud Slaughter? Nobody want to hear that music.
Hey, man. Hey, get off him. What are you doing? Hey, man, get out of here. We need security. You all right, buddy? Buddy, you all right, man? Hey, man, get security. Get this guy out of here. I'll see you one second, man. I'll see you one. I ain't scared of you. This is.
Man, I hope.
Is he out of here? You got security on him?
We got it.
You got security?
We got security. Get him out of here, okay?
Go, please.
Look, yeah, just,
Man.
Hey, get him out of here, all right? Just get him
out.
Man, I'm... It don't matter. This is...
Hey, get him out of here! Did he just hit that guy? Did he just hit...
Oh, man. But let me get him.
Hey, get him. Father Tom, get him. He's hitting people, man.
Hey, look out, man. Get him off of me.
Get security out of here.
Get him off of me, man.
Don't. Dingo, this ain't the place. You can't hit me. Man, you're calling my house. Stop it, man.
Listen, hey, all right. Listen, just, I got it out
here,
okay, man?
Folks, you're gonna have to excuse me. I'm a little, You're a little pumped
up.
I'm a little pissed off.
You want some water?
Listen, man.
Okay, you got some water in there, okay.
Oh,
Father Time, you got him? Is he out of here?
This is crazy.
Hey,
stuff,
you know, I was surprised.
Listen, you know what? There's nothing more disrespectful than barging into my show. My show! This is Figure 4 Radio. This ain't the Dingo show. I'm sitting here giving this guy his props left and right, talking about how much I respect him, and he's gonna barge in, stand over me like a freaking tower? I don't think so. I don't play that crap. Listen. There's a time and a place for this, and that is in the squared circle on March 2nd at the Masonic Temple.
I don't know,
and
man.
If you can't see that, he's going to come in here and start hitting security, start roughing people up in our offices here at FlintTalkRadio.com. Uh-uh! I ain't buying that. Now this shit just got personal.
You know, I tell you something. I'm not sure if Bud's all right or not out there, but I tell you, it was really a bad scuffle out there. One of the security guards...
Is Bud okay?
I don't know. They're 10 to 20 right now, you know. I don't know. You sure you know what you're doing? This man's crazy.
Oh, I know what I'm doing now.
I don't even know why he came down. It's become personal.
You come here and rough up one of my friends? That's Bud Slaughter. He's a legend here in Flint. He's a rock icon in Flint. You going to come in here and lay your hands on him? Well, he didn't put his hands on me. I even got up in his face. What is that about?
I don't know, man, but
March 2nd,
that is
March 2nd,
that is one
folks,
pissed
I'm
going to
tell you right now,
there,
March
you
2nd,
that.
You buy your tickets. You get online right now. ProWrestlingAtItsFinest.com. ProWrestlingAtItsFinest.com and buy some tickets. March 2nd, I'm going to destroy this man. You don't come in here and disrespect me or Father Time or Bud Slaughter or anyone here at FlintTalkRadio.com. I can't even do this show.
Hello? Okay, listen. All right, yeah, okay. I'll make sure. Look. Well, I just got a call from the home office there, and they're not really happy with what's going on here tonight, but I'm going to tell you what we're going to do. They said that they're going to have a contract signing here next week. Next week here Flint Talk Radio. Be there. They're going to get Dingo. They're going to get Dingo the Powerful back here. They're going to have Joe. I mean, Joe and Xavier Justice going to be here next week. And that was really something else to see out there. I've never seen a man get thrown around like that. But they said they're going to have a contract signing next week on this show. They're going to have to beef up security. These two guys, you know, they've been going back and forth over the internet over the last couple of weeks. And it seemed like they were really showing a lot of respect. But he came in here today and really, he put a pretty good hurting on Bud. I hope he's all right out there. But the upper manager said there will be a contract signing next week. I think we're going to have a lot of security here in order to do it. If you want to get your tickets, that's prowrestlingatitsfinest.com. You can get them. The show, it's gotten more big than what I don't know what's going to happen. I really don't. Matter of fact, I'm still hear a little confusion outside.
That's the police. They're trying to see if they want to file. Bud wants to file a report. That's up to Bud. You know, but it's like, you know, it's. Yeah, it was totally uncalled for, you know.
It really was, but you know, things, like I said, I think things have really gotten personal now. This has begun beyond entertainment. This has really gotten first personal, and I think there is a possibility that somebody could get injured. You know, if you want to really find out more about this, you can check out our website, www.prowrestlingatitsfinest.com. You know, this is going to be a main event at the... Matter of fact, I wasn't sure before, but I know now this is going to be a main event. I don't want you to take your mind off the other, but the card is going to be full. You got the Michigan State Championship. That's going to be here. I'll be down there. You're going to see Blue Steel, Sebastian Rode, and Chris Corvison. Okay, I'll let them know. They said that I'm still really shook up about this. I really am. This is really uncalled for today. But, you know, I think what we're going to do now, I'm going to go check and make sure everybody's okay. And like I said, this is March the 2nd. That's Saturday. Less than 3 weeks away on the bricks, Masonic Temple. This is going to be one of the biggest events, I think, that Xavier Justice have ever been in. This is going to be something that's brand new for Pure Pro Wrestling. This is going to be the first time in Michigan that Pure Pro Wrestling has an MMA fighter actually going against a wrestler. And I'm telling you, I think it's going to be really something. So I'm just going to say it one more time. March 2nd, Masonic Temple. Come see us. We'll be there. Father Time, Blue Steel, Xavier Justice, Dingo the Powerful, better known as Grave Digger. You can check us out on Facebook, Dingo, CB Dingo. Check out Xavier Justice on Facebook, Father Times on Facebook. Check us out, Pure Rat Pro. like I said, this has really got me shaken up. So I'm going to go on and check things out. I'm going to go on and say goodbye. Like I always say, there's no time like Father Time. Be there March 2nd. We'll see you then.